Hello guys, welcome to my channel, Mr. Jeff105. One more time, I want to say sorry for those guys that have been following me and I haven't been able to post that many videos in the past few weeks. That's because I've been extremely busy with university, but now that all exams are out of the way, I will be doing soon. And to say thank for waiting for me, I will be doing a full review in a Kickstarter campaign that I backed up last year at the beginning of 2016. It is really amazing. I haven't opened the box, I haven't here. It came three weeks ago and I just can't wait to open it, so I'm gonna show you how it works. My backer number is 2550, and as you can see that, basically what it is a single board computer. It's really amazing. I've not seen that. Well, the name of the device is called LattePanda. And it's being backed up for lots of people. You will see within the video, I'll probably put on the description the website as to where you can find all the information as well. Mainly, I wanted to do an unbox because I've seen several things. Several people have been saying that it gets too warm and things like that. So today, on this full video, we're gonna go through opening, checking what all the packaging is, whether it comes with everything, and then later on I'm gonna show you with a monitor. I have a keyboard and a mouse, and that's all you need. Windows 10, 4 GB of RAM. It's quite powerful for what it is and the size of it. But the problem with these kind of boards is that they get really warm. It's the same as Raspberry Pi. So for that aspect, I'm gonna be working on some kind of project this for summer in order to achieve a really, really low temperature on the board. So let's get into it, guys. Okay. Okay, so the first thing we see is that's the thing. This is just a paper with the showing everything as how it came. Okay, now we find here is the HMI cable. It's a 3 feet long cable, high speed HMI cable, 3 feet. Yeah, let's see what comes inside. Okay, so it's pretty decent. Comes with a very strong nylon kind of a cover inside, and every single one of the caps also covered, which is pretty amazing. So right, yeah, decent. Okay, so what we have here, we have a double-sided micro USB cable for the LattePanda chip for the board. Okay, and then let's open it. It comes with another metal tag here. It's pretty, it looks like very durable as well. Looks fine, yeah. I mean, it's the only thing that's a bit different is the USB side. As you can see, the back, I don't know if you can see there, but look at the, that one, it just looks like a USB, really. A bit weird. The other one is just the same as an Android connection that you would get. I don't know if you can see there. Yeah, it's just the same as that. Okay. I think it's about a meter long. Don't know, let's take it out. See what, like this. Yeah, so normal length that you would expect. It's about a meter long, no more than that. Okay, so that's that. And we got the two bags here, let's put them in there. Oh, okay. To the big guy. The whole package comes with this sponge. They're quite fun, I suppose, but they're really good because it prevents from the packages, small boxes, from clashing or, you know, colliding between each other while the transport comes around. As you can see, my box came with an indentation on the side. It's a bit bended, and I assume this will prevent the inner boxes from breaking or anything like that, right? So what's next? So what we have next, we have, it says, that is for the display. Basically the display, it says a 7-inch IPS display for LattePanda. At the back, not much more, just a few more bits and bobs of information for the so from the company, and that's it. I mean, the case itself seems to be a really nice finish, designed by LattePanda in Shanghai, assembled in China. In China, as it says there, I mean, normal package that you would expect. It's a nice feeling to it. It's just a box, really. Okay, so I'll leave that one here. Right, let's get into the next one. Okay, AC adapter, 5 volt output, 2 amperes, input 100 to 240 volt, 50 to 60 hertz. There's a fast charging thing, and that's it, yeah. That's what we get here in this one. It's alright, it's not bad, it's decent. I mean, the thing is, I'm in the UK, so this adapter will be no use for me technically, unless I buy an adapter. But I assume that if I buy some kind of a use, as long as I have a power supply that supplies 2 amps, it should be fine. So I have my power bank and stuff for me. So there you go. This could be a bit useless, really. It comes with a really shiny, it says scratch to verify the identity. So I'll scratch it. Okay, so basically, yeah, it just proves that it's original, that it comes from LattePanda. That's all it is. So yeah, it's nothing else. It's just a simple scratch card there that says scratch. But yeah, it's alright. Looks robust. We'll open this later on to see. Well, but I don't think I probably will to use it with here, because I don't really have an adapter to this, so there you go. Okay, moving on. So what we have here, next one, we have an acrylic case. Okay, so this is, yes, more or less the same as this, as you can see, the more or less the same layout, a bit bigger. This one is for the display. This other one, yes, acrylic case, LattePanda, for LattePanda. They seem to have a lot of the same name, LattePanda. We think we already know that it's LattePanda, but this is the logo. It looks like a coffee bean, you can see. It's alright. I mean, we'll see how it performs and what it does. Okay, so that's that. That's the acrylic one. Okay, more bubbles. Okay, next one. We have the actual LattePanda. So this box is now empty, so we can get rid of the box. So this is the actual box. LattePanda at the back. It just says that. They're all the same, really. They all come with the same kind of layout at the back. As you can see. Let's see if we can hold them all together. These are these two. Put them like that so you can actually see how they come. So this is the back. As you can see, the model is the same. The same back, same thing on the side. This one, it says a Windows, then computer for everything. So we'll see about that one. And see what the things we can do. This one, it just says designed and made in Shanghai. And the other one doesn't have anything on the sides for the acrylic. Okay. And then it has roughly the layout of the panda in here, which is alright. Okay, so that's that for the unboxing. Let me carry on with the actual unboxing of every single one of these boxes and see what we can find inside. Let's start with a 7-inch display, LattePanda, designed by LattePanda in Shanghai. On this side we got nothing else. We got here, we get the logo. See that? We get the logo there. With the black, get more same reading, some things and stuff. Okay, so what's inside? And you can see, I think the screen comes within the same form as the other pellet that we found in the case. I think it's the same. Alright, seems okay. It seems like it's gonna hold any kind of bumps. We got the screen here. Okay. It looks really nice, it feels nice, it's not really big, it's not really small. I mean, it's the same as my Samsung tablet. And we can compare the size of the screens. Mine is an 8-inch. And let's get this one out of the bag. And this is the actual screen itself. You can see me there. Hello. And then if you put the screen, you can see how big it is. This one is not touch screen. The problem with this campaign is that they said if they get to £250,000 for the amount of money they were asking, they were going to give us an LCD display followed by a touch screen. But apparently the touch screen bit is going to have to be bought from the company, from LattePanda, as an add-on, so it's the only downside. But as you can see, it's alright, but we'll see if it works and how it works and how to connect it as we go along. This is the wire that goes connected to the LattePanda, I assume. It's very, very thin, nothing compared to the Raspberry Pi 3 or anything like that, but we'll see. Okay, so that is the LCD. Next we have the acrylic case, as shown in there. It's more or less the same thing. You get the logo as well. On the sides, it doesn't say anything. That's what you get at the back. Made in Shanghai, little barcode and everything with all the details needed. I mean, okay, let's try to open it and see what we get inside. Okay, so same kind of, I think, oh no, this one doesn't come with any kind of protection or anything surrounding the actual box. So this is all you get on this one. So all you can see here is instructions, I think it is, or some kind of a instruction manual or something like that. So we got okay, so we got these, yeah. All right. The drawing seems to be explosion of the actual assembly of the box, which I think is okay. I mean, if you can understand all the numbering, I think it looks okay. Okay, so the back put to one side, let's put that to one side as well. Okay, so yeah, so we have the first side, which is, seems okay. We have some kind of air ventilation here. I don't know how, if it doesn't come without a fan or anything like that. We have some kind of writing, I don't know if you can see there, with some kind of labeling. They seem that if you push it slightly, they will just come off, which is ideal, and this is what you want when something is being laser cut. The acrylic itself looks to be okay. It comes with a plastic cover in the corner, so as you can see there, so, and it will be very shiny and everything, but yeah. And then it has the engraved also the LattePanda logo in there with the pinned out and the layout of it. It's alright, yeah. And this other one has just little bits and bobs of it that you need to get out when it comes to assembly. So yeah, so that is the case. And then we have, it's only one single piece, so I thought it would be more paper tape, but no. It's just this diagram, that's all you get. A diagram with the LattePanda instructions, and that's it. Please assemble it according to the numerical order. Step 16, 23 and 24 and 25 illustrate the supplementary LED light guide for the plywood case. Okay, so that's in case you have a plywood case, but if you don't, then you're fine. This is how the case should look like when it's finished. As you can see there, it looks alright. I mean, later on, depending on how this one looks, I'm gonna take the measurements and I will make a 3D printed version, so I can 3D print it and make it my own, but I still have two. I still have two cases, but I want the other one to be adaptable. The LattePanda itself. Okay, so what we have here is the box, very nicely done, as what we said here before. It's Windows 10 computer for everything. The box itself, very nice. So we can see here the USB port, I assume. Some kind of SD card slot. I assume this is where the processing power, the processor is. Some kind of switches here. And some kind of ports. I think this is where you put, if you want, this is compatible with Arduino software, so you can actually use some of these sensors, but these were extras, so I didn't want to pay for them, because if you go to FireNL, you can find the actual connectors for these specific connections that they're using, and all you have to do is all the two or three wires depending on what sensor you need, and that's it. So there's no need to pay extra money for that. Back, we got the same thing. That's the dress and everything that we get. Okay, so going back. So let's get it out of the box. Oh, we got still some more things in the box. Okay, let's check the box. What else do we have in this box? So it's some kind of antenna that we need to plug in. Okay, I've not seen this one before, but yeah, we'll figure out what that one has to do. Let's put it there. And we have a little manual in here as well, so safety precautions as always with everything. Okay, yeah, it says the product should be only be connected to an external power supply rated 5 volts with a minimum current of 2 amps, where I said before, so as long as I get 2 amps it will be fine. Customer service, contact us instructions and safe use, instructions for safe use. Okay, to the main thing, to the attraction of this video, which is this, is really really beautiful. I mean, the layout of it is amazing. I do like the layout. It is, but it's not similar in any kind of shape or form to the Raspberry Pi. What's this? Oh, something is smudging. I assume this must be like the heat sinks or something like that that these plates are. Okay, so I assume, well, there's two buttons here. They may, there you push them in. Yeah, okay, cool. So what we have, oh, we have a speed USB, and we have the normal USB connectors, one with mouse, so we have mouse and keyboard, and HMI, I think this is the connector for the screen, and the other one is where if you have the capacitive sensitive a screen panel for the screen, then that goes connected in there. These are the sensors, this is the connection for the extra sensors that you can use. Some GPIO pins in here. Well, I mean, overall this is beautiful. I think it's beautiful. You have a jack. We have the Ethernet cable. We have some port here, and we have, this is the source, where we need to put the 5 volts in for it to work. At the back we have another heatsink, we have some kind of book converter in here probably, in order to step up or step down the voltage, and that is it. Some gold plating, all the soldering seems to be like gold plated in most of the parts, as you can see there. But I mean, overall it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. The layout of it, I love it already. It's really really nice. So next step will be getting to know how to plug it in. First of all, the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna test it on the monitor, and then once we go through the setup and the layout on the monitor, we'll test it on the small screen that we have. Okay, and that's it really guys for the time being. This go to the next step. Okay guys, so now what we're gonna do, we're gonna set it up and see how the connections go. I have tried to power it up and things like that before carry on with the filming, but I had several problems with it, mainly the fact that a lot of the Windows 10 that came with the already pre-installed on the board did not work. So what I had to do, I had to go to the website, download that, install in a pen drive the image that they give you, and then connect it back up again to the pen drive, power the device on, and it would just work. Okay, now I'm using the HMI cable to see how it performs. I'm using keyboard, Ethernet wire for internet, and I'm using, also I'm going to show you, I have a Bluetooth module, I mean a Bluetooth mouse, so I'm going to use that one, or I will also use a wired mouse, if in case you want to see the two functionalities. What I found is that the Bluetooth one lags a bit, whereas the wired one is a bit more firm connection and you get a faster reaction. Also I'm going to power it with power bank. This one is, as you can see there, it has the enough supply for the device. It supplies up to 2 amps, which is what this needs. Also you can use, as always, the Raspberry Pi, which supplies, I think it's that way, yeah, which can supply up to 5 volts. Yeah, have a look at these ones. I've used both of them and both work. So So yeah, so the first thing they advise you to do is to plug in the power. You can see blue LED comes on. Okay, and the back LED will also come on. Then you wait until that light goes out. And then when it goes out, we are ready to start. So now it's gone out. Now what we can do is connect the rest of the things that we have. So we have the keyboard. Okay, the power, the mouse, I'll power the monitor on. We'll get the Ethernet wire and then we'll plug it in this side. Okay, so then you notice that light for the Ethernet comes on. The screen comes on. I'm gonna just place the LattePanda here so you can have a good look. Let me just put it there for you. Okay. And then in order to power it up, we have these push buttons here. And what you have two. So, one second, this is stuck. Okay. There. So you have two, one at the bottom, one on top. You press the top one for 1 second, hold it down, and then you'll see the red light come on again. And then you'll see now the screen. And there it is, LattePanda. I'll zoom in there, guys, for you to be able to see. Okay. And then now it's just a matter of waiting for it to load. Remember that at the moment now the thing is powered by the power bank. And that it is. So, Windows 10. The mouse. I have it connected to a Bluetooth mouse, but I don't know if it's going to work. Well, the pin, that's me. I'll put the pin in. And now it's loading. And here it is. That's my new desktop. Now, as you can see, I'm using the Bluetooth mouse and it's moving fine. Let's go and paint. We could go and paint. And just type in paint. And as you can see here, the response of it that I get is what you normally get with normal computer. It's very, very responsive. Okay. Extremely good. Really, really good. Can see how fast I am running. Okay, to close that, don't save. We have the Arduino IDE. We'll open that one, and here it is. Somehow for this monitor, the size of it doesn't want to fit properly, but I think it's just my monitor. And yeah, and then you can type in. This is the Arduino that is. On this board is the Arduino Leonardo. So we go to tools, we find the Arduino Leonardo, and to test it to see if it works, we can go to examples, go to basics, and go to blink, and it comes up with this window, which is the normal first thing that you would do in any kind of microcontroller, is just set a pin, blink it, and see if it works. So now we're gonna compile it to the board and see if it works. Okay, so it's compiling. It does take a bit of time. We'll see how long it takes. But I mean, overall, guys, I think it's a great product. I'm happy with it. Okay, so that's it. The thing is working. As you can see here, I'm gonna move it in front of the camera, and you'll see that is the LED blink. 1 second on, 1 second off. Some LEDs flashed when I compiled the thing. I'll compile it again and you'll see what I mean. So it's compiling. And then you'll see the few LEDs flash. And it's the same as an Arduino. We have the Arduino reset button here. So if I press that, it'll just reset it, and then it keep blinking again. Yeah, now it's reset. It should be setting itself. And that's it, and then back to the normal code, blinking. So we can tell that the Arduino Leonardo is working, fine on the board. Okay, so back to... Okay, so we know that Arduino Leonardo is working. Let me stop it by uploading just a small thing to keep it off all the time. Okay, I mean the uploading to the board, it takes a bit of time, but yeah, I mean it does the job efficiently. Okay, now we got, I downloaded Chrome because I think it's better than the Internet Explorer, as I'm sure many of you agree with me. I'm having a bit of problem trying to get the thingy to fit the page, but yeah. So basically, let's go to one of my videos and see how it performs. My internet connection is a bit slow today, so you might be seeing a bit of flickering and stuff like that. So we'll click here, we'll click that one, my channel. Okay, so that's my channel, there it is guys. Everything fully working, so I have several of the videos. My temperature sensor, my LCD, let's put this one with a 3D printer on. And let's see if they meet how they sound. There it is. It's flawless. As you can see, it's flawless. I'm gonna turn the volume down now.
Lions roaring in the morning sun, searching for a longer day.
Okay guys, so as you can see it works perfectly fine, it's playing the HD, I mean 720. Let's see if we can play a video, a 4K video. Probably my internet connection is not great, but let's see if we can do 4K. Let's go for someone on the internet and play it. This one seems to be good. I mean, let's go for 1080 and see how that plays. It'll take a bit of time to load. As you can see, my internet is not the greatest connection ever. So we'll just wait for it to load. Okay, let's click play and see what happens. So yeah, I mean, as you can see there, it's playing flawless, the music, everything is really, really nice. I mean, I can't really complain very, very much with that. I mean, it's just amazing how you can play really well. Not lagging or anything, it's just perfectly fine. It's playing it really flawlessly. Okay, and then we can go on to the next one. Let's try 1440 pixels, HD. Let it load for a bit and see how it plays these ones. But as we can see now, we'll just click play again and then see how that delivers. Well, look, the quality is just beautiful. I mean, it does lag a bit because of my internet connection, but overall it's just amazing. We could wait for the thingy to load fully up and then play it. At the moment we're just testing us to see how it will perform. As you can see, it's just flawless. That one is 14. The lagging that you see is not because of the board, it's because of my internet connection hasn't really loaded up fully the video. But yeah, that's what we get. And then if we go into 4K, 2160, it will take a bit more time to load up.
and then we can just see a few seconds, and you probably lags as well because it takes a bit of time for it to fully load up. But we can wait, and then I'll fast forward this bit so you don't have to wait that much. But yeah guys, here's 4K and it's playing with the full thing up, but yeah, I mean, as you guys, the only thing it does lagging is just because the internet connection that I have is not the greatest. Okay, so yeah, I mean, overall guys, I think it's brilliant. I mean, you know, you can even play 4K, I mean, who would have thought? Yeah, I mean guys, that's overall, I mean, the performance of it is really, really good. So let's go to the LattePanda. Okay, so let's go to here and open also the Kickstarter. Where is it? Here. So I'm gonna show you the campaign. But here, my internet connection is a bit of a lag, so I'm sorry for that. Okay guys, so we are in the LattePanda Kickstarter campaign. This was the actual thing that they showed us. As you can see, shipping date April. Mine came 3 weeks ago, and that was, so what's today's date? Today's the 28th. So mine came, yeah, on the 13th of May. So it wasn't really that bad at all. They had 4,060 backers pledged, and 42,735 to help this project bring to life. Okay, so I got this one which says 1.8 gigahertz, 4 RAM, the 64 gigabyte eMMC, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.0, and USB 3.0 plus onboard Arduino processor. If you want to see the actual thing, will go to the campaign and you can see here that the video they used. And yeah, so the video itself is really good.
Existing open source APIs, you can build your own software or hardware projects and then share them to our community.
Yeah, as you can see, so you can come to the campaign and have a look for yourself. It's the first computer that has Windows 10 on it. There's a Raspberry Pi that has all the different things. This is where it says, look, this is where the bit that I'm annoyed about is that it says 250,000 unlocked. And it says a 7-inch capacitive touch panel. So that would mean the screen and the panel that for the touch screen. What I got at pledge, this one, as you can see here, the £99 or more, 918 backers. And then it says you'll get a LattePanda 7-inch display plus everything you need to make it work. Okay, yes, I'm very happy for it. But then here it says that you can get a 7-inch capacity touch panel, which, you know, it just didn't work. I mean, we didn't get it. And a lot of people have been having problems with that and getting annoyed. Okay, so, I mean, that's some of the sensors that you can use. Later on in later videos, I'm going to show you how to make sensors that can go with these connectors in here that we mentioned before. Okay, this is the Arduino. It's smaller than an iPhone 6. And then all you need is just, no, I mean, you can do robots, you can do all sorts of stuff. You can even control a 3D printer, which I'm going to try when I get back home. I'll try that and see if I can do it. Yeah, that's overall. I mean, you have some of the connections here, the connections that we get. So we get Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, done by this module there. We got some Intel GPIO headers, 2.0 USB, 3.0 USB, HMI. We have the touch connector. This is for the capacitive active touch screen. The display is here. We have the Arduino plugin display, and we have, this is the processor quad-core, 1.84 GHz, CPU, 500 MHz GPU. We had the LAN connection, which is the Ethernet cable, the audio jack, the micro SD, and what I described before, and Arduino GPIO pins that we can use. This is some of the descriptions against all the Raspberry Pi 2. Some of them are brilliant, some of them are okay, and some of the pledge things that they did, and that's about it really. So if we go to LattePanda.com, which is the website which is under development at the moment, you can find some useful information about it. So we go, but for the problem I had to go to docs, and then in here it says introduction, getting started, welcome to LattePanda documentation, this guy will show you how to get started. Let's quickly go over what you see. Okay, then I went to the troubleshooting, and here in this button, this side, and this is what I did. Basically, how to reinstall LattePanda Windows system. Can't start up your Windows system properly. Windows system crashes. That's what I was having. I was having mainly these two here, and it's just not working. So mine is a 4 GB and 64 GB RAM. For my LattePanda, so I downloaded this, put it into a pen drive. The pen drive has to be formatted and called, formatted using the FAT32 and NAPE WIMP. WIMP is what they called it, just a funny name. Plug in, unplug, and then you'll see by the time it finishes done doing all the resetting, it will just, all you have to do is take the pen drive off. And that's it. One of the mistakes I made was that when I downloaded this zip file, I unzipped it, but I unzipped the folder within the pen drive that I was going to use. The pen drive has to be bigger than 6 gigabytes in order for it to work, because this is like 5.8 gigabytes. It's quite big. What you have to do is unzip the file, but don't copy that file straight to the pen drive. What you have to do is open the file and all the folders within that file, copy it to the pen drive, and that way it will work, because I did it the other way and it did not work. So yeah, that's about it. That, but I mean, do check this website, is helpful, and it shows you, you know, what to do, plug it in, what to expect, the LED that we went through, the GPIO pins, the switch on power, and some of the connections. This picture is really good because it's for the Arduino side, and what the connectors, as you can see, these connectors here on the left hand side, we know that if I blow it up a bit, okay, so as you can see here, well, this side, it says D9, so digital 9, 5 volts and ground, so we know which ones are digital and analog. We can just make these sensors to our like and plug them in. You see, there's no need to buy extras, okay. It's just something that I think is too expensive what they're asking for these connectors, for these kind of connections, if you want any extras. As you'll see them, where is it? If I go back into, oh yeah, here, look, for example, just the, if you want the same, this is the display that came with, so we're going to test it in a minute on that display as well and see how it works. $29 for the display, that's how it looks like. Yeah, and it will show something about that. Okay, a bit of information. The website is good for information and things like that. It's not that bad. Not that I'm doing publicity for them, but they're useful. Okay, and then yeah, that's some of the comments. And that's what I mean. If we put here, if you go to Latte, let me find it. LattePanda. Okay, so click search, is searching. I mean, the reaction to search is quite good for the device. You can see now the first one, which is a 2 GB with 32 GB, is basically £109. A dollar, sorry. And then the one I have is $139. The acrylic box that I have is there. These are the sensors. Look, they're asking for some sensors and a few wires, $60. You see? So I will show you how to make those sensors later on. This is the adapter and things like that. It is a bit on the expensive side. I've had to order this one. I've ordered that one. It's coming through soon. You know, but it's not really cheap. But I want to see if I can do more projects. I need it to be touch screen rather than having a mouse. But I mean, if you want to use this, is another website that I found. It has a lot of information in it. Really, really nice. I'll put the link below, and it has everything you need to know about the thing, specifically the specification side. If you go right to the bottom, you can see there, and it's just really, really well written. Okay, that's mainly everything. Now what we're gonna do, I am gonna I'm gonna power this one off. I'm gonna use the small display now to see how it performs on that, and then you just shoot it down as a normal PC will do. Shoot down and shooting down, then it goes off and that's it. Okay guys, so let's go test it on the actual display, which is here behind the LattePanda. What I'm gonna do, the connector is on this side. Make sure you have the actual flap for the connector is at the front. It's here, as you can see it moving there. So what you do, you just put it through the back. Make sure you put it in the right way. And then just put the connector in all the way. Make sure it's firmly in, because otherwise it just does not work. And then press down the thing that holds it. So now you just pull and make sure it's firm. The connection has been made. I'm gonna power the LattePanda now from here. 1, 2, the light comes on, and then the screen, there it is, LattePanda. The mouse is also connected, and then we'll just wait and see what happens. The quality of the screen is really good as well. Just give it some time to load. The whole device is still powered from my power bank, so as you can see, this thing can be very, very portable. And I have this 22,000 milliamp hours, which can last me for 2 days non-stop to charge my phone. This uses very little power as well, which is really good. As you can see here, the screen is back to working. That's me again. And then yeah, so that is the LCD. So let me log in. And here it is, that's my desktop. So as you can see, we have the Arduino IDE, we have Chrome, everything. I mean, it works just really nicely. We'll play some footage as well. Close that one. Okay. Yeah, so let's go to my channel. My internet is a bit lag. It's lagging. I don't want you to be judging the device because of the internet. Please, let's put okay, welcome back. Let's put this one. I mean, the internet, the thing is not connected to the jack. This is my water wheel that I made this year for university. It's a civil competition. We came second overall. And yeah, I mean, it's playing really well. Okay, that's that. And yeah, guys, that is it. And then we can go and paint proper halves. And we look for paint here. We can also have for when you do the touch screen thing, you can use this as a tablet kind of a thing, so you have a keyboard here on the screen. Yeah, and then we can make this bigger, and then we can just paint and put Mr. Jeff. See, it's very responsive. I mean, you can do anything with it. Look, it's so responsive. I mean, there's no lag to it. Can you see how responsive that is? It's just amazing. You might see the screen a bit dark because I had to put it the light of, otherwise you won't be able to see anything if it's too dark. The screen behind is so good. I love it. And then, yeah, I mean, that's it overall, guys. I mean, it all comes down to you, really, just to what you're really after. I mean, you can see everything. Yeah, everything. Oh, yeah, one more thing. If you go, if you have a 3D printer or anything like that, there's a guy that has, if you go into Thingiverse, let's go to my things. I think it is. Lord, I have a few things. I'm also, this is my printer, so I am making I have made a Thingiverse, so you can follow me. And if you have the same printer, please feel free to make an enclosure. That will be my next project. And here are several of the pictures that I made. So this is those blocks that I made, so they can fit perfectly over the printer. This is when they were getting made. I mean, feel free to have a look and chill. Yeah, it's a really nice piece of kit that I just got. Yeah, this is the table that I got agreed from IKEA for £5. There's a few links that I put in there. I mean, if you want to come around, and feel free. Also for this LattePanda, there are people that made already enclosures. This one, for example, I've just found really, really useful, and I think I'm gonna print that first thing. Look, it's just a case. Instead of having it on my hand right now, as you can see, I'm gonna put like this little case that this guy has made. It seems to be really, really nice. And there's the stand. We can see that is the case, yeah, and then things you may need. I think that looks like double-sided tape, a few pads to prevent from slipping, the screen, the LattePanda, and the rest of the stuff is really interesting. That's how it will fit. I mean, I don't think you can ask for any more, really. He's put that nicely there, the antenna, very nicely done. I think I'm gonna do that so we can reuse it. It's really, really good. Okay, and then as soon as I get this out of the way, I'll post a new video showing you the build for this as well. And that's it, really, I think. That's all I have for you for the time being. I mean, let me know whether you like this review, whether you didn't. I mean, it's always, you know, it's always a good thing whether you, all your comments are very well received. There are several companies that are behind me at the moment asking for me to do reviews of different devices and things like that, so the next one will be coming soon for a temperature sensor, also for several kits that you can get from websites and things like that. Yeah, so I think it will be nice to start doing some reviews. You know, you can always follow me on my channel. I mean, feel free to do so anytime. Don't forget to subscribe. You know, you can always press subscribe here. Follow me on Facebook. Yeah, I'm on Facebook as well. So here, as you can see, yeah, and then you can just follow me there. However, that's the page for the. I upload this more often than I do my YouTube channel. So this is one of the new persons that's trying to. She says, "Dear Jefferson, how's your day? This is Vanya from icstation.com. I have visited your channel on YouTube and your projects are really awesome. We are an ICS product retailer and specialized in IC components, modules, robot sensors and so on. As you are interested in electronics projects, would you like reviewing for us?" So yeah. I mean, you know, if you would like anybody, if you would like any kind of reviews from me, yeah, I mean, my videos take about 3 weeks to get done. I look into the stuff, I see whether they're worth the money, whether they're not. But mainly, your comments, guys, your comments are the main thing for me. You know, that thumbs up thing that you may have, that's always welcome. And it's only one click away, you know, it can make a big difference, that one like on that video. I mean, as you can see, I still have several other videos on my channel, and some of them are for electronics. I'm thinking the one you would like is my let me log in. My RC car that I made. The internet's a bit slow today. So okay, so if we go to my channel. Okay, so if you go to videos, you know, I have this one. I think you should check that one out. Definitely check that one out. That was I did it with an 80 Tiny and Arduino. Code is in the description if you want to use it, feel free. It's a really nice piece of kit, a H-bridge, and the actual board is so small. The other one is just a H-bridge, but it can be even small. It's basically a very small breadboard, a few bolts, 18 bolts I think I used for that one. And then, I mean, it goes round the crack, makes a full lap, no problem. It took me about a week to build it, but that's because I was doing reports and things like that as well for university. But I mean, if you want to learn how to build something like that, please let me know. And then I'll do a full tutorial on it. The code for this particular one is down in the description below. You can find it there. And yeah, feel free. You know. Alright. So I think that is it for me, guys. So don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much.